做的琴，他已经达到世界顶尖水平。哎，把这个换的钱拿来做弹琴，我已经负债累累，人家总觉得你是个疯子。这架琴如果做不成的话，我可能就会离开这个人世了。
This is an industrial park in the suburbs of Nanjing. At around 6 a.m., Zheng Gengning begins his day's work. He's polishing the wooden skeleton of a piano. He's among the few craftsmen in the world who can produce handmade pianos from scratch. While his piano workshop seems shabby and cluttered, 7 grand pianos are displayed in the showroom. Each of them was once played by a renowned Chinese or foreign pianist. Their autographs stand out amongst the wood and metal. Today, the crucial step of polishing the wooden frame for the cast iron plate will be undertaken. The cast iron plate is just like the chassis of a car and will determine the piano's acoustics. The wooden frame directly affects the quality of the plate. There's no room for error.
这个木模摆了一年多没用了，它会变形的，木头做的嘛。它经过这个空气的含水力的变化，所以呢，我后来发现这个木模表面不平了。这个东西必须要平，如果不平的话，你这个钢琴架就做不好。Zheng
is now working on a 9-foot piano, the standard size for grand pianos used in formal competitions and concerts. Zheng is hoping to make a grand piano possessing the finest tone. This is why he bought a gantry milling machine and installed a computer numerical control system.
钢琴它是一个综合性的一个那个车前喜报，我都能干。我觉得做任何一件事啊，你只要认真，就没有做不成的事儿。 我家里弄个机子。 你怎么弄的？你怎么弄的？你告诉我你怎么弄的？那你好，你弄去，我来摆。好。你瞧瞧，你瞧瞧，我来摆。这个英文字母一点都不能错，错的一个人笑死了。你要说这个做怎么做钢琴的人没文化嘛？能做什么好钢琴啊 ？China，中国。Zheng
is 55 years old. He can neither play the piano, nor has he received any formal training in the manufacturing of musical instruments. He's a classical music enthusiast and an audiophile, which seems to be enough.
说来也巧，就是我们几个音响发烧友，我们每个星期基本上都要在一起聚会。那么我就问他们，我说国外的这些唱片里面的这些钢琴有没有中国的钢琴？然后他们说没有。后来我就说。
It was at that moment that Zheng began harboring the idea of making a piano. He'd previously run a photographic business and had successfully made a chromatic printer. Money wasn't a problem for him. So in 2000, with a playful mind, Zheng began work on his first handmade piano.
我想嘛，拿个几十万出来，就试试看吧。行就行，不行拉倒。反正就比如这个钱，或者丢掉了，或者什么其他的损失掉了，也无所谓，也就几十万。He
was surprised to find out that the piano manufacturing process was far more complicated than he originally thought. As one of the most sophisticated instruments in the world. Making a piano involves dozens of procedures and tens of thousands of components. One seemingly minor error will greatly affect the overall quality of the instrument. There was no one Zheng could turn to for advice. He had to figure out each step on his own.
I have a great advantage. 然后我就在不断的改，那么改了以后重新再做。 我想一个个问题解决以后，说不定我明天我的琴就能做到世界顶级水平。
8 months later, his first upright piano was completed. However, it didn't make a sound. The second and the third piano had the same problem. In spite of his family and friends' advice, he invested another ¥1,000,000 in making 12 4.5-foot grand pianos. But there was only a slight improvement in tonality. Years passed like this, and Zheng used up all his money from the photo business. In order to continue his piano making, he sold his photo store and also his house. He decided to use his final ¥3,000,000 to try and produce a 9-foot grand piano.
对我来说，这个九尺琴就是背水一战，我必须成功。我想这架琴如果做不成的话，我可能就会离开这个人世了，因为我是一个自尊心非常强的人，因为我无法去面对我的家庭，面对我的朋友。
This time, Zheng chose the finest timber and carefully checked over each component. In the summer of 2006, after 6 years of effort, he finally succeeded in manufacturing his first generation 9-foot grand piano with a greatly improved tonality.
来，一、二、三，来，再吃。
The wooden frame for the cast iron plate has been well polished. Then the frame needs to be cast. This is the most important step in piano making. Zheng had to finish this procedure outside his workshop.
好，行，这不对了，肯定要摆直。
After selling his house, Zheng moved into his workshop. He lives alone. The small factory has 4 workers: a carpenter, an assistant, a cook, and himself.
哎，饭饭好，人定了，没得事，吃不要紧。好，哎，定到了。
把那木料拿过来，对，
对。哎，这不下来了吗？我勒个乖乖！今天去铸造厂，去放那个钢琴上面那个铸铁架，很重要的一个部件。好，那我们走吧。
Zheng's fourth generation 9-foot piano is aimed at improving the pitch of higher notes.A perfect cast iron plate holds the key to achieving that. In order to find a factory to process the cast iron plate he designed, Zheng searched far and wide across Jiangsu province. He finally found one 30 kilometers away in the town of Li Shui. This moderately sized factory is a family-run business. When Zheng came here for the first time, he touched the former manager's heart with his sincerity and passion.
按照正常状态呢，我们肯定不会接这个订单。第一，批量很小；第二，我觉得有点疯狂吧。这个，但是后来的话，可能是我父亲跟他接触以后，我父亲对他这个人生经历和他这个应该说像这个已经痴情了呀。
Although the foundry agreed to process the cast iron plate without making a profit, the cost of making a piano is still costly.With the rising cost of materials and labor, the manufacturing fee has increased, as well as the rent for the factory, staff wages, and other daily expenses. Having now worked in the piano industry for 14 years, Zheng has gradually become known to people in this small circle. He began to think about how to sell his pianos.
那个时候呢，我也在想，能想能让它能卖点出去。这样呢，我能更好的去发展，我能更好的去做更多的琴。但是最终结果很令我失望。
Since 2006, Zheng has taken part in various musical instrument exhibitions at his own expense. So far, it's cost him 2 million yuan. His pianos did manage to attract some attention, but no one ended up buying one. In 2012, with a little help from his friends, Zheng invested 200,000 yuan and opened a piano store. But the business failed to turn a profit. In order to raise more money for the manufacturing of pianos, he turned the store into a fruit shop. Unlike assembly line production, handmade pianos don't have a fixed process. Technical mistakes and changes caused by outside factors can easily creep into the mix. The constant rainy days are a concern for Zheng. Early in the morning, he comes to check on the soundboard. This determines the resonance and plays a key role in the instrument's tonality. The humidity is too much for the wood to take. This drives Zheng towards making a decision. This soundboard took 2 months to make. It was made from a complete piece of Himalayan spruce, the best material for pianos. It cost him an arm and a leg and was very difficult to find.
对对对，这个德国的蔡司哥来卡的这个这个干净不净壳啊，是那个是。我在那个大定坊工业园21号。哎，这是我过去搞摄影时候用的，现在舍得舍不得，因为我现在要做钢琴啊，把这个换的钱拿来做钢琴。
这都是过去比较经典的德国镜头，这边大概也能卖到5万块钱吧。来来来，上来上来上来，走这边上来。这哎对，走这个楼梯上来，对对对。
三先生，你这个镜头是在哪一年？对的，
大概是98年吧，98年吧。98年，嗯。
镜头上面有一点瑕疵，这个来你看啊，用放大镜才能看得出来，可能你。
这个是这个，这个是灰，
这个不是灰尘，这个不是灰尘。
这个你可能我来吹一下，我来吹一下，我吹一下看看。反正镜头的状况就在这儿，你自己看吧，反正你就开个价吧。我当时买来是26,600的，
一个整数差不多了吧？你看
多少啊？
10,000。10,000太低了。
26,600，开什么玩笑？而且这个镜头这个东西，
这也不是开玩笑。
不是，它也不会坏的这个东西。
After some bargaining, Zheng sells the lens for 14,000 yuan. Jung speeds up his work on the last soundboard. If he makes any mistakes this time, his dream of making the grand piano will be shattered. It takes tens of millions of yuan to set up a well-equipped piano factory. The temperature and humidity has to be carefully controlled. This kind of investment is out of the question for Jung. He has to make a loan payment of 30,000 yuan each month, which puts what he's doing into perspective. Handmade pianos have a soul which is incomparable to pianos made on the factory production line. World-famous consumer-grade pianos are all manufactured on production lines and assembled by hand during the final steps. Even top-level pianos like Austria's Bösendorfer, the handmade part of the process is only about 60 or 70%. But Jung's pianos are more than 90% handmade. Only a few craftsmen in Germany still make pianos by hand. And in China, Jung is treading a solitary path. Since he began making grand pianos, Jung has led a monotonous and rather routine existence. He usually stays in the factory all day long. But every few days, he has to head downtown.
这个钢琴它的钢琴放在这儿比放在厂里面好，为什么呢？这个地方是有空调的，整个房间里面呢比较干，所以保存在这种环境里面还是不错的。主要呢，这个钢琴放在作为一种展示，能够让更多的人知道张丹宁钢琴这个品牌。我现在呢就是觉得，既然是一个制作钢琴的，那么它绝对不是一个商人，因为制作和商人它是两个行业。
Abandoning the idea of selling his pianos, Jung begins to think of other possibilities. A hospital in Nanjing wants a piano to celebrate its 120th anniversary. A staff member approaches Jung for advice. Jung volunteers to lend his piano to the hospital for free, but he has one condition.
I 说那保多少钱呢？我说，那就保700万吧。他说啊，他说为什么要保这么高啊？ 我说80年代德国人为美国白宫做的一架琴，就是600万美金。他说好，就保700万吧。
Jung's grand piano is a beautiful centerpiece in the hospital's foyer. Each month, Jung comes here to do some maintenance work. Each day, around 2,000 patients and their families can enjoy 4 hours of piano performances. More and more people are learning about Jung's handmade piano. Back at the foundry, the cast iron plate is ready. Since it's Friday, Jung decides to invite his best friends over for dinner. His friends include pianists, musical faculty, as well as entrepreneurs. They've all lent their encouragement to him over the years.
Jung 老师完全胜任，并且有这个勇气去赶超，就是说国际一流的钢琴制造业，而且是以手工的方式。
他曾经对我说过一句话，他说我就不信中国人，13亿人口。为什么就不能制造出世界顶级的钢琴？后来我理解了，正是这句话支撑他抛弃了非常非常多。
After the cast iron plate is finished, manufacturing the grand piano reaches the final stage of assembly and tempering. Jung hopes one day to take the piano to the Concerthaus Berlin for a charity performance, as a way to introduce his handmade piano to the world. All he needs is another million yuan to make it happen.